give my yes to you today. I choose.
Good morning. It's Monday, the 10th of June, and I trust you got a decent cup of coffee for Coffee with God this morning. If you have your Bibles, turn to James 4, verse 4. Jacobus 4, verse 4. You adulteresses, do you not know that friendship with the world is hostility toward God? Therefore, whoever wants to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God. So I want to focus on that last part. You know, at one stage in many years ago, the people used to talk about being seeker sensitive, making your churches appear like the world and easy for the world, the people of the world to fit in. And I just thought of when I heard that and I was thinking about it this morning again, John the Baptist would never have been hired by any of our modern day churches. He was just too radical, just too way out there. Remember, he wore clothes made of camel hair, he had a leather belt around his waist. He ate honey and locusts and came out of the wilderness preaching a message of repentance. And even when the people came close to be baptized for their sins, he shouted out and warned them, "Who's warned you against the coming wrath?" He wasn't a very gracious and a very approachable and a very likable, fit-in kind of guy. And I want to say to you this morning, you be true to yourself and don't be a chameleon. Don't try and be a friend of the world, because in the process, you'll be making yourself an enemy of God. And that's with outward physical appearance. That's with speech, with the way you talk, the language that you pick up and then you use. Make sure that the Holy Spirit is the filter through which you do life. Maak die Heilige Gees die filter waardeur jy die lewe dan aanpak. Laat hy jou woorde skat suiwer. Laat hy jou klere drag en jou motief en jou intensies. Laat hy dit bepaal met sy teenwoordigheid. And I think then we will live a more impactful and a more striking, contrasting life to those in the world. So be careful. He starts off by calling them adulteresses. He says, you're married to one and yet you're currying favor with another. Be careful. Be very, very careful. Stick to the one true God. Stick to the one true relationship that you have in your life and live out of that relationship. Allow that relationship to affect and influence everything that you do, the way you move, the way you carry yourself, the way you speak, the way you do things. Don't try and befriend the world. Be yourself in the world. Think about it and have a wonderful, wonderful Monday. May the Lord bless you.